today. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to do somewhat of an unboxing, and we're going to talk about how I package my plushies when I do markets. All right, so let's just get right into the video. All right, so let's just talk about the packaging first, and then we'll talk about the unboxing. So this last market that I did in November, that market I had tried to do, I tried to attend a couple years ago, but here in Texas, you never know when it's gonna rain, when it's gonna be windy, when the sun's gonna be out, like today. But so in that market, we showed up, it was windy, it was rainy, then the winds picked up even more, and then the winds picked up even more, and things were flying, tents were flying. And so it made it a little difficult to do the market. So we ended up leaving and losing out on $220. And that was a couple years ago. So we did do it this last time, and I thought I need to be prepared because I can't have my plushies flying in the dirt, you know, or flying in the mud. Let me adjust this camera. It's a little wonky. I do apologize. Hopefully that's better. I don't think it is, but let's see. Okay, maybe that's better. So so I thought I have to find a way to protect these plushies, and I kind of went everywhere looking for a way to be able to package and protect my plushies. I was looking for something that they could still see the plushie, where they could still pick it up and kind of feel it. And I thought about all kinds of different things. I even thought about doing like, you know, the Reynolds wrap. Oh my gosh, I even thought of doing that, but I thought, no, that's not gonna look good. So I came across these basket gift bags, and I got these at Michael's, and they have all different sizes, and they were really inexpensive. So if you are a small business owner and you're just starting out like I am, especially selling plushies, and you're doing markets and you just never know what the weather is going to look like, I highly suggest these because number one, they protect it completely. Number two, you can really make the packaging look really, really nice by adding a bow. I just used twine for mine at this particular market because it was in November, and but I did, if they bought it for a gift, then I changed out the twine and put a nice bow ribbon on there to make it look more like a gift. So that's one way that I thought of doing my protecting my plushies, because I did look on Amazon and I saw a lot of good options, but they were not budget friendly. So like I said, if you're a small business and you're just starting out and you're just trying to figure out a way to protect your plushies, number one, from kids getting them dirty and adults and wind disasters, rain disasters, all of those things, then I highly suggest that you try to one of these basket gift wraps. Excuse me. Okay, so now I wanted to do this full unboxing that I got, and I thought, okay, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna open the box. So I started the video, and I got interrupted. I forgot to put do not disturb, and it cut the video. And so I'm like, oh, this totally just wrecks it all. So let me just, here's the box. Here's where it came in. You can tell that it's pretty big, and it is a Michael's haul. Now, Michael's knows really how to bring you in. They'll give you a $5 reward, a $10 reward, and you're like, oh, okay, let me take a looky look, right? Yes, that's what happened to me. I got the email, oh, here's your $10 reward, and it was going to expire. Now, you don't want to just waste the $10. And I thought, what do I need? I thought of getting some more packaging things, but then I thought, no, I don't need that right now. Maybe I should see what other sales they have on things that I do buy from Michael. So I looked around, looked at some Cricut cut things, looked at different things, and I thought, no, I don't really need vinyl. I don't really play a whole lot with, you know, the Cricut. So I thought, no, let me see what else they have. They don't have embroidery things, and they don't really have a lot of sewing things. So I thought, well, let's take a look at the little yarn. Maybe they have a good sale. They had the buy one, get one 50% off. And so I thought, well, let me jump on that bandwagon and let me take a look at what this is gonna cost me, you know? So I did, I got the Loops and Brown Chanel Home Slim. And this is the first time I think that I'm getting this brand. I've gotten, I can't remember. No, I think I've gotten it before, but not these colors, I don't think. Yeah, no, I don't have these colors at all. So we're gonna take a look at this. I'm gonna share it with those, since we're just gonna pretend that I unboxed it here on this video, and we're just gonna get right to it, okay? So let's get started. I got the Loops and Thread Chenille Home Slim yarn. I got the mustard. Hopefully you could see that. And I cannot wait to start making these. I'm still working on a project that I'm trying to finish, and it's that blanket for my daughter. I didn't finish it for Christmas. That was just one of the gifts that I was gonna give her. I bought her something else, but I felt like, I always like to give a handmade gift to my children, just so that they have something from me in case something ever happens to me, they'll have a memory. But anyways, I'm almost done with that blanket. I want to be done with that before I start getting into my plushie making again, because I have a lot of ideas. And I don't know, are you like me? Do you have like all these ideas that you want to make? I literally had to create like a to-do list of all of the plushies that I want to make, and where to get the pattern, because, well, yeah, like I needed to get organized, I guess, because I have so many ideas, not only to make plushies, but embroidery and sewing. Like I have a few sewing projects that I want to do. But you know, this, yeah. So let's get back into this. Okay. The next color that I got, I went on a little tangent then, sorry, is Boysenberry. I think this is so pretty. Like, this is such a pretty color, and I only got one of these. So one of the mustard, one of the boysenberry. I got two of these agave. I didn't want to say they're agave. I don't know. Anyways, I got two of these. I think these will be cute for turtles. That's what I'm seeing. So I got two of those to make turtles. But look at Michael's. Hello. What's going on with this, Michael's? This is how it came in my box. Yeah. And then I got, oh, this color right here is so pretty. I think I want to go back online and see if they have any more sales, because yes, Michael's did give me another $10 reward voucher, and of course I need to spend it, right? We cannot waste the $10. So I think that I want to go back on, and I'm probably going to get another boysenberry, another mustard, and another one of these. Where's the color? Country blue. Isn't that pretty? Like, oh my god, I love blues. Like, oh, it's so soft too. I don't know what I'm gonna make with that, but I just got it because it was pretty, and it was buy one get one 50% off. And then I also got sand. I think I'm gonna get another sand. I think this would be cute to make the little plushies, like when you make the people. I think, you know, to make the skin, that will look nice. So I'll see if I get another one. I know I want another country blue, and then this, is it boysenberry? Yeah, wait, let me see. I think that's what it is. Yeah, boysenberry. I definitely want to get one of those, and maybe another mustard. And then I got these, the multicolor yarn. And this is a bulky five. What are these? Are these five or four? Oh, these are six, and then these are a five. But I love the color. I'm telling you, I love the color blue. And this one is, let's see if I find the color, blueberry. Oh no, this is not blueberry, this one's blueberry. Sorry about that. These were only $3. They were $3.33, and so I got them. I had more in my cart, but I guess I was still, you know, too slow in shopping, that people were buying them and then they were saying, oops, we're out of order. And I was like, oh, that sucks. So anyways, these were $3.33 and I ordered more. So this is just part of my order. I still haven't received the other part, which is, I think it's getting here this week. And then this one is, where is the color? Where is the color? Okay, I can't even find a darn color on this one. Let's see. This one was... Give me a second. Give me a second here. This was the blueberry. Now I can't find the color, you guys. This one... Where the heck is it at? Sunset. It's autumn sunset. That's what it is. This one's autumn sunset. Isn't that pretty? They're two. They're both blues. This is a darker blue. It looks like it looks purple, but it's, well, maybe it is a purple. And then this one is an autumn sunset. Really pretty. I ordered more because these were only $3.33. Originally $7.99. And so I was like, well, I need to get some of those too. And so I did get these. And then I know that I ordered more of these. So before I place another order, I need to make sure that I didn't already order this. So I'm going to log on Michael's and see where that order is at. I know, I think I'm going to get it this week, it said. And then place another order because I do have another $10 to spend. And I don't, and I'm not doing any markets anytime soon, so I don't need these. So I don't want to buy these yet because I know that Michael's will give me another $10, and then I can use that just to buy like packaging supplies and stuff like that. So that I can package the, so what I like to do is once I'm done with my little plushie, I like to put it in its package and then put its price on there. And then, you know, of course, if I'm going to ship it out, I'll change out like the ribbon, or I'll add the stickers and cards and stuff like that in it. And so that's how, that's what I like to do, just so that they're ready, because the last time I had just thrown everything in a huge container from Target, those plastic containers. And then there I was at last minute trying to get them all done and packaged and priced. And this way, everything's already there and done. Like, you know, I'll take the photos, add them to my website, put them in the package, because that's how I'm going to ship them out to online customers as well. I'm going to put them in these packages, because not only will it protect your plushie, because you never know what can happen to a box that you put it in or a bag that you put it in. You never know if it's going to rip, and at least that will protect it. It has another layer of protection from rain, or, you know, shipping while it's going through the shipping process, it's getting dirty. You know, it'll avoid that, because I know that I've ordered stuff and the box has come beat up, and then the items are like just shown, and it's one of my items had gotten dirty. And I was like, wow, like, so to me, I want to provide that extra protection, because you don't know where it's going to be shipped and what that climate is looking like. So I think these are good to put your plushies in, even if you're shipping, and then put them into a box or one of those bags, you know, that your, or those big envelope bag thingies that, you know, shipping things, shipping supplies, right? Just so that it's protected, because you want your customer to come back and be like, look at the packaging. My item was protected. It was double layered or triple layer, whatever, you know, whatever the situation may be. And then they'll come back because they know that when they buy from you, their item is being extra taken care of as it's being shipped, if that makes any sense. So that's all I have for today's video. I hope that this was insightful as far as packaging, especially if you're on a budget or you just didn't know like what kind of idea to put. Because I know it took me a while. Like, I had to go and look around to really figure out what I knew what I wanted when I was looking for packaging, you know, to package my plushies in. I kind of knew what I wanted, but I didn't know where to look, if that made any sense. This was actually in the baking section of Michael's. So not where you would think it would be, like, you know, packaging or, you know, where they have the gift supplies stuff. No, this was actually in the bakery section. That's where I found it. I did look at Amazon. I did look at different options on Amazon, and I thought, well, I'm on a budget. So I'm a some very tiny business on a budget, and I need to find things that are user friendly because I need to use that money in different ways, right? And so that's why I came up with that. So I hope that, you know, that helps you with, you know, your packaging ideas, especially if you're on a budget. It's, you know, and it looks good, right? It looks good. All right, so I hope that was insightful. I'll talk to you soon.